When you come down to hunt for treasures, be sure to include another, a classic meal, at the iconic Fife landmark, Poodle Dog Restaurant.
I like the people, of course. The people I work with, the customers.
Claudia has been serving loyal Poodle Dog customers for over 40 years, and the staff stays busy. More than 4,500 customers sit down to a meal every week. At least 800 stop by for breakfast on a Saturday morning.
People still want sit-down, full-service dining experience, and they want that, the relationship with the server. And I think a lot of the history is our staff.
The Poodle Dog took its name from the San Francisco Ritz Poodle Dog, and it's woven into Fife history. It began as a humble hamburger stand in 1933 behind a barbershop and next to the Century Ballroom along Highway 99. It boasted two tables and a 15-seat counter with the best burgers in town for 10 cents. The names of today's favorite dishes honor the early history.
We have Highway 99 skillet, 54th Street skillet, and my landmark breakfast, which is our number one selling item.
Over the years, the burger stand grew, getting an impressive drive-in look in 1951. Some customers swear their car is in this picture. Others remember their visit to the Poodle Dog on their wedding night.
It was actually a high-end restaurant of its day in that time, during the 50s and 60s.
As the restaurant grew and refined its look, one thing remained the same, the bright neon-lighted Poodle Dog sign.
I'm trying to register it with the state of Washington to become a historic landmark. That's a big part of our history.
2015 brought a complete renovation, including the classic pup room lounge and the banquet rooms that accommodate up to 350 people. Thankfully, the Poodle Dog spirit remains. From Claudia serving your chicken fried steak to Miss Jane, marking 36 years making fresh pies and pastries, to the famous and favorite dishes on the menu, the Poodle Dog experience is a treasure.
We're a true classic diner, and we really hold true to that.
For Rainier Country, I'm Laurel McQuaid.